Revelations 4. Revelations chapter 4. I'm going to be reading out of the message, okay? If you guys have anything, you can put it up. Then I looked up and a door opened into heaven. The trumpet voice, the first voice in my vision called out, "Ascend and enter. I'll show you what happens next." I was caught up at once in deep worship, and a throne was set in heaven with one seated on the throne. Suffused in gem hues of amber and flames, with a nimbus of emerald, 24 thrones circled the throne, with 24 elders seated, white-robed, gold-crowned. Lightning flash and thunder crash pulsed from the throne. Seven fire-blazing torches fronted the throne. These are the sevenfold spirits of God. Before the throne, it was like a clear crystal sea. Prowling around the throne were four animals, all eyes. Eyes to look ahead, eyes to look behind. The first animal like a lion, the second like an ox, the third with a human face, the fourth with an eagle in flight. The four animals were winged, each with six wings. They were all eyes, seeing around and within. And they chanted night and day, never taking a break. Holy, holy, holy is God our Master, sovereign, strong, the was, the is, the coming. Every time the animals gave glory and honor and thanks to the one seated on the throne, the age after age, living one, the 24 elders would fall prostrate before the one seated on the throne. They worshipped the age after age, living one. They threw their crowns at the foot of the throne, chanting, "Worthy, O Master, yes, our God, take the glory, the honor, the power. You created it all. It was created because you wanted it." So lift both your hands right now into heaven. Our hands are lifted, our Father. We surrender to you. Would you break off the restrictions, oh God? We step into eternity right now. We step into eternity right now. We step into eternity right now. Big in the unsuve if cosamante stays. Bada sinis if alcuna mantis in this. Rumuda bakis in el casavasu stage. Jekunta paskire in the caskis. Ma antubre el cascamantis. Betoshka pakis in Gizaha. Zekuta baleke brefos, sikiris, lokuta bakiza, zefege suka papa iris, leti makaya, sikiri, zama katulu, sikiri.
Oh, Yeah.
there and it'll hit you like a frying pan on your face. Do you understand? You have to want this thing. Listen, God can touch every single person around you. If it's not your heart desire, you will miss out. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Sing it over. a lot of diseases, a lot of sicknesses. In case you have anything at all, I just want you to come outside here. And I want us to all worship the King of Kings, the I am that I am, the one who was and is to come, the Ila. He is the Ila, he is the Ila. So in case you have any disease, any pain, any fear, I don't know, I don't want to care of anything you are going through. I just want you to just come here, worship the King of Kings, worship the I am that I am, the one alone that can heal your disease. He has promised us, and I just see if God. God, come forward, come here and worship him. Come here and worship him. Open your heart, worship him. He is here tonight and he's ready to heal you of your pain. He's ready to heal you of your sickness. He's ready to take all the infirmities away out of your body. He can also come here and stand in gap for your families.
I'm not afraid to die.
for you. You would think peace for you. Things that happen to you are not things that God wants. Because God is only good. God is only good. He's no other kind of thing. He's only good. And he's a father. He's such a good father. But the devil also knows this, yeah. And so he would do stuff to you that would make you think otherwise. But see, we are learning to praise ourselves out of peace. We are learning to praise ourselves out of tunnels. We are learning to praise ourselves out of wells. The devil would do what he would do, but we praise ourselves out of peace. We are songs of deliverance. The Bible says God is singing songs over you. I was singing songs of deliverance. When I say I was singing songs of deliverance, that the Father has my name on it. Amen. And something I'm learning recently, God, that in a crowd of how many people that are here, if God calls somebody, he calls you by name. 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 In the crowd of, I don't know how many people are here, if God calls me, he calls my name. He doesn't call my entire family. He doesn't call my group. He calls my name. He calls my name. And so whatever things you're in right now, it doesn't matter what, you sing yourself out of it. Nobody has to lay hands on you. Nobody has to lay hands. They don't have to prophesy. You can sing yourself out of it. You can sing yourself out of it. The moment you remember that, the devil knows. The devil knows. The devil knows that whatever things it brings you away, you sing yourself out of it. You shout yourself out of it. You get loud if you have to. You get loud if you have to. So right now, how we did this recently in church, but we're going to do this again right now. We're going to get loud. We're going to get loud. We have liberty to get loud. We're going to get loud. We're going to get loud. And we're going to praise ourselves out of this. We're going to praise ourselves out of this. We're going to praise ourselves. 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 We're going to sing this song. We're going to sing this song. Yeah.
and I'm wondering why.